former President Fidel Ramos, Excellencies of the Diplomatic Corps, Secretary Armin Luistro, Senator Jun Magsaysay, Mr. Johnny Santos, Ms. Carmencita Abella, the 2014 Ramon Magsaysay Awardees, Ms. Hu Shuli, Ms. Saur Marlina Manuring, Mr. Omara Khan Masudi, the Citizens Foundation, Mr. Wang Chanfa, Mr. Randy Halasan, the Board of Trustees of the Ramon Magsaysay Awards Foundation, past Ramon Magsaysay Awardees, fellow workers of government, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, again, a very pleasant good evening. In a sense, all of us here today are heirs of Ramon Magsaysay's legacy. I do not refer only to those who had a personal relationship with him or to those who still have living memories of him. Each of us who has been called to serve is challenged to live up to the standards that he set. Even before there was an ASEAN, and even before East Asia and Southeast Asia began to get to know each other better and create the strong linkages we enjoy today, the Magsaysay Award already existed to serve as a regional recognition of excellence. For more than two generations, the roster of Magsaysay laureates has been a scroll of honor and a clarion call to others. These awards have recognized those who have dedicated their lives to serving the marginalized and the oppressed, while at the same time mobilizing entire communities to follow suit. Truly, whenever one feels overcome by cynicism, one can count on the Magsaysay Awards to point towards hope, towards stories of individuals who, confronted by the darkness of despair, have chosen to serve as beacons of light. This year's roster is no different. It is composed of individuals imbued with the missionary zeal to promote social justice, and each one of them has taken a very personal stand to contribute to the improvement of the communities in which they live. For all of us who strive to make this world a more inclusive place, the road to empowerment begins in the place of learning. It is here where we can share knowledge that enables an individual to maximize opportunities as they come. The innovations of Ms. Saur Marlina Manuring and Mr. Randy Halasan, who have poured their hearts and souls into their work to educate indigenous communities, bear witness to this. Along with more traditional classroom subjects, they are teaching immediately applicable life skills, such as farming and awareness of the basic rights of each individual. Together with the example of the Citizens Foundation based in Pakistan, which has been focused on education for all, regardless of religion, gender, or economic status. These prove that learning must go beyond entrenched methods and curricula. It is one of the most critical pathways to self-value and empowerment, and we must treat it as such. With empowerment comes the challenge of discernment, to know one's rights and responsibilities, to safeguard the treasures of our past, and to make sense of our individual milieus for the purpose of ensuring that governments always remain true to their core mission of improving people's lives. Therefore, we also recognize our winners in other fields. We have Mr. Wang Chanfa, a lawyer from China who has worked tirelessly to protect the environmental rights of pollution victims and to hold polluters accountable. We have Mr. Omari Khan Masudi, who, while working in the National Museum of Afghanistan, went to great lengths to literally hide his country's cultural treasures from those who threatened to steal or destroy them. And we have Ms. Hu Shuli, a prominent Chinese journalist who has ably fulfilled their duties as a journalist towards promoting good governance. Each of these individuals has confronted, at times, long-standing problems or their latest permutations, and found innovative and inclusive ways to address them. In other words, they have not been content to complain, but have been inspired to act, with solutions that are relevant and replicable. I am hopeful that the honor they receive today will serve as a challenge to all of us, reminding us that in our respective fields of expertise, we each have the capacity to help those who have less. In President Ramon Magsaysay's day, the challenge was how democracy could strengthen newly independent nations in the face of tyranny and totalitarianism. Today's challenges, on the other hand, ask us how we can harness democracy to make sure that our progress is felt by every last citizen, especially by those who are most vulnerable. President Magsaysay in his credo had already envisioned our pursuit of inclusive growth. He said that, and I quote, The little man is fundamentally entitled to a little bit more food in his stomach, a little more cloth on his back, and a little more roof over his head, close quote. This is precisely what all of us, including myself and our awardees today, continue to aspire for. How we respond to this challenge of uplifting our fellow men in the margins will determine what history will write about our generation. Moving forward, I'm hopeful that more men and women will follow the footsteps of Ramon Magsaysay and our awardees today, so that we may work together and rise up to the challenge of our times. Fulfill the collective promise of our world and bequeath to future generations a global community that is, without doubt, better than we found it. Thank you. Good day.